before I get started with this video, I'd like to invite you to follow me on Instagram at ashton.blue. No spaces, that should be on the screen right now. I've noticed I've never shown my face or anything, so if for some reason you did have an interest in my personal life or just wanted to see what I looked like, you could feel free to request to follow my account. Again, ashton.blue. Anyway, enjoy the video. Alright, hello guys, today we're going to be talking about an upcoming major winter storm that's going to be affecting the southern Rockies into the central United States and then up into the mid-Atlantic and northeastern United States. We're going to break this one down using the GFS precipitation type. You can see this is where it's going to be located in the southern Rockies to begin with. This is kind of Saturday night, so tomorrow night. Then we're going to move on to 18D Sunday. So this is kind of afternoon, evening on Sunday. And you can see this has moved into the central United States and it's moving into the mid-Atlantic states. We're going to move on another one. And by Monday morning, early Monday morning, probably about 2 a.m. on Monday, you can see it's moved into the mid-Atlantic states and it's heading towards the northeast. New York City, D.C. getting snow. We're also looking at Pittsburgh getting some, Philadelphia, you're all snow, Boston starting to get some snow, as well as Providence, Rhode Island. Now we're going to be moving on one more, and you can see this is where it's getting really heavy here for Philadelphia, New York City, Providence, and Boston, all of you getting very heavy snow. And you can see as we move on to Monday afternoon, coastal Maine, Boston still getting all that snow, very heavy. We're going to be looking at our total snowfall now across the entire United States. A lot of those southern Rockies you can see in the green color, that's 12 to 20 inches of snow there for the mountains, but that's nothing too crazy for you guys. As we move into the plains of Colorado or eastern Colorado and western Kansas, you can see we do have some of those 6 to 10 inch amounts in the pinks, and in the purples we're looking at 4 to 6 inches, so that's a pretty good snowfall amount for you guys. Southern Missouri, northern Arkansas, we're also looking at 6 inches plus in those pink areas, a lot of purples, which is 4 to 6 inches again for all of you guys. But I want to zoom in on the northeastern United States. This is where things could really change a lot. We could see this go south or north. It's really a question mark at this point. West Virginia, you're looking at 6 to 10 inches of snow. A lot of the peaks getting 12 inches or more. Northern Virginia, same story. DC, you could be looking at 6 inches plus. Baltimore, same story. Northern Delaware, all the same story. Philadelphia, most of New Jersey, we're all looking at 6 to 12 inches as well. You can see some of that green, that's where we're looking at 12 to 14 inches there for coastal New Jersey in some portions. New York City, you're in the 6 to 10 inch amounts as well. Providence and Boston, especially south of Boston, you're looking at 12 to 16 inches of snow according to this model run. We're going to move on to the FE3 GFS, and this is a test model. We've seen this one put out a little bit of heavier numbers throughout storms, and this one tends to not be too accurate. I am going to show it, though. But we see a lot more of those greens, which means a lot more of those 12 to 18-inch amounts from West Virginia and Northern Virginia all the way through Boston. So Philadelphia, New York City, Providence, Boston, all looking at those green amounts. Same story on the NAM, looks very similar, just a little bit lighter with the precipitation amounts, but you can still see a lot of those pinks and greens in there. The GEM, you're a little bit further north on the GEM, and this is really a risk with this one. This is why you shouldn't get your hopes up quite yet. There is a chance, but we do see some of the models showing it further north, and this would put New York City and Philadelphia where they're mixing with a lot of precipitation and probably not too much accumulation. At least not near a foot like some models are showing. DC, almost nothing on this model. So we do need to pay attention to the fact that this could swing north or south or right down the middle. And last but not least, here's your European model, which is a little bit further north as well. Philadelphia, New York City, not getting too much snow, right around 6 inches. Philadelphia even less, maybe 2 to 3 inches on this one. DC, practically nothing. Baltimore, practically nothing. And really, you see the highlight from central eastern Pennsylvania up through northwestern New Jersey and north of New York City and New York. Only northern Connecticut and northern Rhode Island and northern Massachusetts getting a lot of those amounts. Boston, it's looking quite promising for you guys. Looks like you guys could get quite a bit of snow, but southern New Hampshire going to look to get bullseye according to the European model, and as well as coastal Maine. So we're going to keep a very close eye on this one and continue to track. We're still a few days out, so we will see which direction this moves in, whether it's north or south. But nevertheless, please consider subscribing as I will continue to update everyone on this storm as we get new information. Anyway, guys, I'll see you in the next video, hopefully.